Hello, B here, and welcome to Integrated Physics and Chemistry. Today's lesson is going to be all about the teeny tiny but very mighty atom. An atom is the smallest particle of an element that has all of the properties of that element. It is the basic building blocks of matter that make up everything. But before we get started, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to define the three subatomic particles that make up an atom, compare and contrast the three subatomic particles of an atom, and discuss the relationship between the identity of an element and its subatomic particles. The prefix sub has many meanings, one of which is part of something. Thinking about this definition, what do you think a subatomic particle is? Subatomic particles are the particles that make up the atom, the protons, neutrons, and electrons. We are going to start by discussing protons, which are symbolized with a lowercase p with a little plus sign on the top right. Located in the nucleus of the atom, protons have a positive charge and a mass of one atomic mass unit, or AMU. The most important thing to remember about protons is that they determine the identity of an atom. All atoms of the same element have the same number of protons. It will never change. For example, every atom that contains 6 protons is a carbon atom. If it does not have 6 protons, it can't be a carbon atom. It must be a different element. In fact, every element has a different number of protons. The proton is not the only subatomic particle located in the nucleus. It has a roommate, the neutron. A neutron does not have a charge and is therefore neutral. Its symbol is a lowercase n with a little zero on the top right. And like the proton, it has a mass of one atomic mass unit. While the proton's job is to identify the element, the neutron has a completely different job. The neutron's job is to hold the nucleus together. As we know, protons are positively charged and packed in a dense nucleus. But we also know that when two particles of the same charge come near each other, they naturally repel. This is where the neutron comes in. Its job is to act like a buffer between these positively charged protons repelling each other. I like to think of the neutrons as the referee in a boxing match. They keep the boxers apart before the match. One big difference between protons and neutrons is that atoms of the same element can have different numbers of neutrons. For example, all atoms of hydrogen have one proton, but they can have a different number of neutrons. Finally, we come to the tiny, energetic electrons. These subatomic particles are like little kids who were given too much sugar. If you put them in a large, open space, they will run around at top speed, taking up as much space as possible. Electrons, with all of their energy, are found in the electron cloud, which is a large region of mostly empty space surrounding the nucleus. Electrons are negatively charged and very small. In fact, they have an approximate mass that is 1/2000th the mass of a proton. This means it would take around 2,000 electrons to equal the mass of one proton or neutron. This mass is so small that scientists consider it negligible, meaning it isn't even taken into account in the mass of an atom. Think of a grain of sand being added to a bowling ball. The grain of sand doesn't meaningfully affect the mass of the bowling ball because it is so small. The symbol of an electron is a lowercase e with a little negative sign on the top right. Similar to neutrons, atoms of the same element can have different numbers of electrons. Woo! That was a lot of information. It might be helpful to look at it in one clear table. So let's make one. I want you to pause the video and try to complete the table in your PDF on your own first. When you're finished, hit play and let's check your work together. Welcome back! Let's see how you did. Compare your table to the table on the screen. How did you do? If you had some trouble, don't worry too much because we will review it in the lesson PDF. And remember, you can always go back and rewatch the video if you want. If you look closely at this periodic table, you will see a number in the box of each element. These numbers start with a 1 in hydrogen's box and increase by 1 as you move from left to right, then down to the next row. This number is called the atomic number. If you remember, every atom of carbon has 6 protons. If it doesn't have 6 protons, it is not a carbon atom. So, what do you think this means about the atomic number of an element? The atomic number tells you the number of protons present in every atom of that element. But remember, in addition to positively charged protons, there are also negatively charged electrons. With this in mind, how can the atomic number help us understand what is needed for an atom to be neutral? When an atom is neutral, the atomic number also tells you the number of electrons in an atom. Another important piece of information about an atom is not found on the periodic table. This is the atom's mass number. The mass number is the mass of a single atom measured in atomic mass units. Now, think back to what we know about protons, neutrons, and electrons. What do we know about their mass? The mass of a proton and a neutron are each 1 AMU, while an electron is so small that its mass is not taken into account in the mass of an atom. The mass number of an atom is equal to the number of protons plus the number of neutrons in the atom. The mass number is not found on the periodic table, but why do you think that is? Remember when we learned that atoms of the same element can have a different number of neutrons? That means they can have a different mass number too. So the variations of this number aren't shown on the periodic table. However, you might see the atomic mass for each element on the periodic table. This is found by averaging the mass of all of the versions of an element together. Since you can't find the mass number on the periodic table, you would need to know the number of neutrons present in an atom to determine it. Conversely, if you already know the mass number, you can determine the number of neutrons in the atom. One way you can be given the mass number is using this atomic representation. In this representation, the mass number is the top number, and the atomic number is the bottom number. For example, in this representation of carbon, the mass number is 12 and the atomic number is 6. Using this information, we can determine that there are 6 neutrons because the mass number, 12, minus the number of protons, also known as the atomic number, 6, is equal to the number of neutrons, 6. You will have more practice with determining the mass number and the number of subatomic particles in the lesson PDF. As we went through the lesson today, we defined the 3 main subatomic particles: protons, neutrons, and electrons. and discussed their similarities and differences. We also learned how these subatomic particles relate to specific elements and the periodic table. Your next lesson will be a PHET activity, further exploring the structure of the atom. Until next time, remember that the universe is vast and full of surprises, so never stop exploring. Hey, hey.